Hello there. It's your favorite time of the week, Mayor Monday. I'm Mayor Acquanetta Warren. I hope you had an amazing weekend. This past Friday, Fontana had its first ever Spring Street Night Market. It was so much fun. There were vendors and even a live DJ. It was definitely a night to remember. Before we get into today's announcements, I wanted to provide an update on the South Fontana Park construction. Take a look at this video. Hello everyone, it's Mayor Acquanetta Warren in the great city of Fontana at our brand new park, South Fontana Park. I'm so excited, it's almost done. Because of the maintenance period, we're gonna have this park open hopefully no later than February 2023. But I think it's important for us to understand what's actually going on out here. You're gonna see some shots of progress, but we're gonna talk to some of the team leaders that have assembled this great team together to make this park happen. So our first discussion will be with our Deputy City Manager, Phil Byrne.
Thank you, Mayor, appreciate that. Yeah, the team has been working feverishly to get this done. Was one of the first big projects that the council assigned to my group when I first came on board with the city. And our engineering team has really done an amazing job. We had our groundbreaking in January. A typical park turnaround time that we've built historically, and Daniel will be able to speak more to this, is about 24 months. This one's gonna be substantially completed in about 10. Once we get through this, in about 3 weeks, we should have all the landscaping in. So it'll start in the growth period, and we'll have the landscapers monitor the maintenance. So by February 1st-ish, we should be able to open it to the public. So we're very excited about the work that the team's done. This is an outstanding facility. 4 football, soccer fields, a major tot lot, which we're staying in now, an exercise area. The team was very excited to put this together and has really done an outstanding job getting us to this point. So we're looking forward to an opening.
This is fantastic. Did you hear that, everyone? 24 months historically, but in this project, they were able to sweeten it down to 10 months. Now, part of the process is what's gonna happen when the park is completed. So we have our community services director, Daniel Schneider, here to talk about that.
Thank you, Mayor. I just wanna reiterate what Phil said. Our CSD group, Community Services Department, we were a bit surprised to find out that within a 10-month period, this park was going to be done, developed, and built. So we're super excited. Shout out to the engineering team, public works team. But in addition to that, I wanted to talk a little bit about how probably 3-4 years ago, we did a survey throughout the city and noticed that in the south, we didn't have enough football soccer fields. So we took that to the city council, and all the credit to our city council and our great leadership, we decided to build to the south. So that's what we're gonna have here. We're extremely excited for all of our rental groups, our resident youth nonprofit groups, and just as important is our own community services department, Pee Wee Sports Groups. So many people to the south, on occasions they would have to go up to the north or to the core of the city to participate, but now they can stay in their own backyard in the south. So we're really excited about it. Staff is ecstatic. We've heard nothing but praise. We're super excited for the beginning of 2023.
We're getting a lot of calls, a lot of emails, a lot of text messages, and on Instagram and Facebook. People are excited about this new park. They want it open today. Well, maybe not today, but hang in there with us because it's gonna happen. When you talked about people having to go to the core in the north, that was for the organized sports because we just didn't have the fields down here, but now we do.
Yes, absolutely. We did not have the fields to the south. We had baseball fields, softball fields. We just did not have the number of soccer fields that's needed for the south. So you all, city council, gave us the direction to build Central City Park, which is in the core of the city, and then now South Fontana Park, which is gonna serve the south residents. So we now have, I believe, 8 soccer football fields up to the north. We should have 6 soccer fields in the core, and then now we'll have these 4. So it's a little bit more of a equity for the south here.
You know what, I'm really excited. This is more of an infrastructure update throughout the town. We're gonna be talking about some other projects pending too to give you a good view of what's happening. But there was a big rumor in the community that we would not have playground equipment. So I wanted us to be right here where you can all see that there is playground equipment and there is shelters that cover you when you want to have a birthday party, or we've seen weddings out at the Nature Center. There's all kinds of activities that you can do at our great parks. 58 parks, can you imagine? 58 great parks. So I'd like to thank you gentlemen for joining me today, and I'm gonna put it on my calendar. Around the beginning of February 2023, we'll be announcing the grand opening, and you don't want to miss it because we're going to have a great time out here. And since we're on the subject talking about great times, as we always say in Fontana, Fontana together moves Fontana forward. I want to reiterate that staff and the construction crews are working hard to deliver this park as soon as possible. Some of you have communicated that the construction is inconvenient, and I know it's not ideal, but it's necessary. Thank you for your patience and understanding while we continue to move Fontana forward. Now, let's get to this week's announcements. Just a reminder that the City of Fontana has resumed passport services. Services are offered through appointment only. Walk-in services are no longer provided. Appointments are available Monday through Thursday from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. Visit www.passports.fontana.org for more information or to schedule your appointment. Next, have you seen this year's city's official Halloween guide? Hope so. There is something for everyone, even for your pets. On Saturday, October 22nd, from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m., the Fontana Dog Park will be hosting the Halloween Howl. Come out and get your doggies dressed up in a costume and take them to the Halloween parade at the Fontana Dog Park, located at 15556 Summit Avenue. All dogs must be on a leash and admission is free. For more information about the Halloween Howl or this month's Halloween festivities, visit fontana.org or call 909-349-6900. Approved yard sale days are coming up. Remember, permits are no longer required if the yard sales and garage sales are on specified dates. The next yard sale dates are November 4th, 5th, and 6th. This is the first weekend of November. If for any reason you need to hold a yard sale outside of those dates, visit fontana.org to fill out an emergency yard sale permit or call 909-854-8020 for more information. Lastly, the City of Fontana Youth Community Theater is back and invites the community to get ready to roar with local talented youth as they perform The Lion King Jr. at the Steelworkers Auditorium. Tickets are only $15 per seat and can be purchased at the Art Depot Gallery, located at 16822 Spring Street, from Wednesday through Friday from 12 p.m. to 8 p.m. and Saturdays and Sundays 12 p.m. to 5 p.m. Or you can purchase your tickets online at arts.fontana.org. If you would like more information, call 909-349-6942. I hope to see you there. Well, that's all I have for this week. Until next time, Fontana together moves Fontana forward.